Hello and welcome everyone to the YouTube channel of LearnBay.co.
So yesterday we have taken an introduction towards the data visualization using Power BI, and we have seen what is Power BI, why Power BI is there in the market, and we have tried to understand the power of Power BI, how powerful and how easily it allows us to create the different type of visuals. And when so easy, we can get a detailed information about the data. That is the power of Power BI. And the last visual which we have covered in Power BI was a Gate chart, right? So we will proceed further in today's session, and we will talk about few more visuals, and we will also see how to create a report in Power BI. So let's proceed further. The next visual which comes up over here is a cards in Power BI, right? So there are different type of cards in Power BI. Here it is. These are known as the cards. So let me quickly create a card in Power BI. So I have already logged into the Power BI and I have connected to the same data source which we were using yesterday. Now, when it comes to, and yesterday I've also told you that in Power BI, in one page, we can have multiple visuals. Okay, so here you can see there is something written as 1, 2, 3. This is known as a card. You can take this double click on the card and you will be getting the card on your page. Okay, we have multiple types of cards in Power BI, like date card, number card, text card, dynamic card, right? So I will tell you all of these different type of cards. So this is a card. It has only one field. And suppose you wanted to display, I want to put the subcategory over here. Let me put the subcategory and let's see what does it displays. It displays accessories over here. It's indicating it is a first subcategory. Now, what do you mean by first subcategory? First subcategory means as per the data source, it is appearing first in the list. So if I create a table over here and let me take the subcategory, and let me also quickly increase the size. I told you yesterday how to increase the size of the default size. So I can go to the view and let me go to the customize current theme. Let me see the text size. Let me make it as 16. They apply. Here it is. So you can see in the list of the subcategories, accessories is the first subcategory. Okay, let me take one more card over here. 1, 2, 3. And again, I will take the subcategory. Either I can drop it over here or I can also drag and drop it over here. This is again displaying the first subcategory. You can click on this drop down arrow if you want the last. So it is giving the last subcategory over here. So in the list, the last one is tables. So it has been arranged alphabetically. So the first and the last subcategory is being displayed over here. I can take one more card. And again, I will take the subcategory over here. I will put the subcategory over here. I will click on this drop down arrow. First, last, then we have count distinct. So it will give you the number of categories. So they are overall 17 subcategories. Let me take another card over here. And again, I will take subcategory. You can also click on the subcategory. And you can simply say count. So it is displaying total number of records, that is 9,994. Okay, so these are known as a text card where we have put in a text value within the card. So that is known as a text card. So these are the text card we have over here. Right, let us take one more example over here. Again, I will take the card and let me put the sales. Now I will put a numeric value over here and then it will be referred to as a number card. Basically, the card is one. Depending on the utilization, we call it as a text card, date card, or the number card. So let me take the sales over here. Here is the sales. So it is displaying the overall sales I have. Right? Now you also want to display the profit. Let me take another card and I will like to put profit over here into the fields. So it is displaying the profit, and you can also copy paste it. Control C and Control V works over here. So you have got a copy of it, and instead of profit, I will like to display the quantity. And let me copy paste this. And let me take this as discount. Right, so these are known as the date cards over here. Okay, and let us try to do some formatting onto it. I will go to the sales. I will click on the formatting option. Then you will few options like data labels. You can change the color of the data labels. Let's take, I want it as orange. Right, so this is the data label, or let's put some different color. I would like to take it as golden. Right, so these are the data label. Display units is fine. Size, okay, everything is fine. Then we have the category at the bottom, sales. This is the category. You can make it off, it will be removed. You can make it on and you can change the color of it. Let us take some different color. I'm taking orange color over here. This is how it is appearing. Then title is off. If you want to give some background color, I would like to give some background color over here. Right. I have taken the background color over here. You can give the border shadow, and let me take the border color as say golden, and I will like to make it as a rounded corner border. Here it goes. So see, you have done all the formatting you want on the sales. It is appearing like this. Now, again, you have to do the same formatting for profit as well. Suppose you have to do the same formatting for the profit. So I can take this, I can go to the format printer, and I can simply click on this. So easily you will be getting the copy over here. You need not to do the entire formatting again. If you wanted to change the decimal places, you can go to the format, data labels, decimal places. Let me make it as 0, 286,000. Yes, this is fine. All right. Similarly, you can take the format for the quantity and for the discount as well. So I have created a card over here for sales, profit, discount, and quantity. Let me put, so these are the number cards over here. Let us take some visual. I would like to take. Let us take this a pie, where I will display the sales on the basis of region. Here it is. Let me go over here to the formatting. I don't want the legend. Quick formatting I'm doing over here, and detailed labels. And removing the title prompt. Right. Now you say, and I will take quickly one more option over here, region wise. Let me take another one. Oops. Let me take this. Sales on the basis of category. Here it is, and I will display the data labels over here as well. The data labels. Now you click on technology and see what happens. All your visuals are giving the details only for the technology. All the cards are displaying the information. Let me take about South. So you're getting the sales of the South, sales, profit, discount, and quantity. All the details of South is being displayed over here. So now it has become a dynamic number card over here. Okay. So these are known as the number cards. And let me also take one more card over here, in which I would like to display. I'm talking you, giving you an example of a dynamic card. Let me take the subcategory over here. Here it is. I have taken this. Now, what I will do, furniture, yes, it is fine. Now, let me take, I have selected this visual. I will take the subcategory into the filter on this visual. I'm taking it into the filters tab, and you will see basic filtering. I don't want basic filtering. You will click on this. You will say top N. I want top one on the basis of sales. So I will put the sales into the values and say apply filter. Here it goes. Now it is saying first subcategory, but it is not the first subcategory. I will say rename this visual and max revenue generating. Oh, where I have taken. Sorry, I have clicked on the wrong visual. So remember, when you are dealing with the multiple visuals, you have to select the appropriate one. So rename max revenue. Here it is. Maximum revenue has been provided by phones. If you want, you can also use the format over here as well. All right. Now, so here I have a dynamic text card as well. I will click on technology. The max revenue generating is phones. If I click on furniture, the maximum revenue generating is chairs. If I click on office supplies, the maximum revenue generating is storage. Okay. So this is the dynamic cards we have over here. So I have given you the example of a date and the text, sorry, the number and the text card. Let us take another type of card, which is known as a date card. So let me take this card and let me put an order date in this. Now you can see you are getting over here as earliest order date. Earliest order date. What do you mean by this? This means that overall in the four, we have the data of 4 years, 2014 to 2017. So we have got the first, our first order was received on 3rd of January, 2014. Okay. Then let me take some visual over here. I will like to take a bar chart for the sales on the basis of region, and I will display the data labels. Okay, and let me make a copy of this, and I will take sales on the basis of category. Okay, now you say technology. Let me click on technology. In technology, the first order was received on 6th of January 2014. If I talk of furniture, the first order was on 6th January. If I talk of office supply, the first order was on 3rd January. Let us take from the western region, it was 6th January, we received the first order. East, we 5th January, we received the first order. Central, 3rd January, we received the first order. And south, the first order was received on 6th of January. So this is what we are getting over here, the first order date. But I'm not looking for the first order date. What I want the date on which I have received the maximum revenue. Maximum sales has been done on which particular date. So for this, I will take the order date and I will put it into the filter on this visual. Remember, this is selected filter on this visual. Instead of basic filtering, I will say top N. I will say top one by on the basis of sales. And don't forget to click on apply. Here it is. Tuesday, March 18, 2014. Is the date where we have received the maximum sales. So let me give it an appropriate label. So instead of earlier order date, I will say rename this visual and I will say max sales generated. Maximum sales generated. This is appearing over here. Okay, now let's take technology. It is Tuesday, March 18th. September 17, 2015 is the date where we have received the maximum sales in the furniture category. Office supplies. September 23rd, 2014 is the date on which we have received the maximum sales under the office supplies category. Let us take South. In the South region, March 18. Central, 2nd October 2016. East, 22nd of October 2017. And 23rd March 2017 in West. Okay, let me create. And if you wanted to do some visualization, some formatting onto this, you can do the formatting part also. So let's go to the format. And I can go to the data label. I can change the color. I want the color to be golden over here once again. Category also I'm putting as golden. So here we are getting, so this is the date where we have achieved the maximum sales. Similarly, if you want, you can also take the one, let me copy paste this, or let's create another one. Copy paste is also fine. Here it is. Now, here I would like to, instead of max sales generated, let me remove the order date from here. It is displaying the order date. I will put the order date over here once again into the filter on this visual. Instead of basic filtering, I will say top N. I want bottom one. Instead of top, I will take bottom one and I will say on the basis of sales and say apply filter. Here it is. Sunday, July 9, 2017 was the day where we received the minimum sales in the Western region. Okay. And if you wanted to do some formatting, Here it is, and you can do some formatting also. Here it is. So here we are getting the maximum and the minimum sales received on which particular date is being displayed over here. Right. Here it is. Another very important feature of date is, let me reduce the size of this. Okay. And I will make a copy of this. Okay, now there is something known as relative date. Now let's see what is a relative date. So I will remove this from here and I will remove the filter as well. And I will remove this also. Here it is. And I will put order date over here. Order date. I will also put the order date into the filter. Instead of basic filtering, I will go with the relative date. And in the last, I will say 6 years. Now, what do you mean by relative date? Relative date is date with relation to the current date. The date in relation to the current date is known as the relative date. In the last 6 years, say apply, and I will also add one more data field over here. Let me take the sales over here. Instead of advanced filtering, I will say top N, top one, top one on the basis of sales, and say apply filter. 2nd October. So in the last 6 years, remember I have the data from 2014 to 2017. So the 6 year will be, that will be 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So starting from 2016, it will be the last 6 years. So now you can say, and I will say, here is max sales in last 6 years. Here it is. Now you click on technology and see what happens. Let's take furniture. You can see Thursday, August 17, 2017. So now it is calculating, and here you can say Thursday, September. What is the date appearing over? December 17, 2015. So if you will talk about the overall data, the maximum sales for in the furniture category was on September 2017-2015, but in the last 6 years, the maximum sales was on August 17, 2017. Okay, so the beauty of Power BI over here is that it is real time. When you are saying the relative date is with respect to the current date. So if you will open this report tomorrow, this date will change because it will take the 6 year from the tomorrow's date. Okay. Is it making sense? Is it clear? Oh, somebody says, how the values are changing automatically. Okay. So yes, by default, whatever visuals we put on the Power BI page, they are responsive to each other, which we have talked about yesterday also. So all the visuals are responsive to each other. Okay, thank you. Is it all going good? Is it okay? Please type in yes. Thank you. Thank you for the response. Let's proceed. So here I just told you about the cards, and let us take, we have one more type of card, which is known as a multi-row card. So here is the multi-row card over here. And by default, as you have seen the card, which I have created, every card contains only one value, but let's create a multi-row card. So here you can have multiple values within the card. So let us try to take the customer name. Let me put the customer name over here, and you will see all the names of all the customers are being displayed in this card. If you will scroll down, you will see the details of all them. The name of all the customers are being displayed over here. Okay, so this is known as a multi-row card, and I will also like to put sales over here. So customer-wise sales is being displayed over here. Now, supposedly, I want to display the top three customers, the top three customer on the basis of the sales. So I will put the customer name into the filter on this visual. Instead of basic filtering, I will say top, and I wanted to show top three on the basis of sales and say apply filter. Here it goes. So I'm getting the top three customers on the basis of the sales. Let me quickly do some formatting over here. So I can go to the format. Let me go to the journal and see if anything important over here. Fight, finding, nothing over there in journal. Let us see the data label. So let me change some color to the data label. I will like to make it as golden. So you can see that the data color has been changed. You can increase the size. Let's take 24. Okay. Then if you want to change the font and all, you can do that. Category, you can see the sales is known as the category. I will remove this. I don't want to display sales and sales again. Card title, this is known as the card title, the name of the customer. So I can make it golden as well. And let's try to increase the size. It's too big. Yes, this is fine. We can go to the card and outline. Can you see this line over here? Show bar, no. The bar has been removed, no outline. Okay, title, I don't want, any title. Show bar, card. Okay, card title, where it has gone. Category, I can switch off the category. So the sales and sales, which was displaying again and again, has been removed. And quickly on the background also. Background, and we can give the border, we can give the shadow, You can put the border colors over here. You can make it as a rounded corner border so it looks good. Here it is. Here it goes, and if you see it is not appearing in a sorted manner, so I can click on this drop down and you can say sort by sales, and you can say sort descending. Sort descending. So I'm getting the top three customers over here, and data labels. Right. So here we have, now see the beauty what I wanted to do over here. Let me take a bar chart over here. And I wanted to display the sales on the basis of segment. Sales on the basis of segment. And let me also display the data labels. Here it is. Now you see, just focus on this card and you click on the consumer. So you are getting different names over here. If I say corporate, you will see different names. If I will say home office, you will see different names. And if I will click outside, you will see the different names. Okay, so we are getting the details of the customers who have done the maximum projects. Maximum revenue has been generated by these three customers. Right. So dynamic, dates, relative, multi-row card, here it goes. Right. So these are the different type of cards which we can create in Power BI. Next. Now comes the filters in Power BI. What are filters in Power BI? So if you will see, there are four types of filters. You will see, let me create some visual over here. Let me take the sales on the basis of subcategory. Here it goes. If you want, you can also put the data labels. Right. Now you will see three sections over here, filter on this visual, filter on this page, and filter on all pages. So I have taken this. I will also take one more visual where I would like to take this, or this will be better. Sales. On the basis of category. Category wise sales. Let me put it into the axis. So I'm getting category wise sales over here, and let me put the category into the legend as well. Here also, I would like to put category into the legend. Now you say filter on this visual. So let me take the category and put it onto filter on this visual. And here you can see you want furniture, office supplies, technology. So if you see, it is impacting only the visual on which I have created the filter. It is not impacting the other visual, but I don't want this. I want my visual should impact all the visuals, or my filter should impact all the visuals which are there on the page. Okay, so here we have second option. Let me take select all. Let me close this. And I will take the sales and I put it onto the filter on this page. So any visual which is there on this, so let me take. Oh, sorry. Filter on this visual we have done. Okay, let me take the category and I will take it on filter on this page. Let me browse through it. And I will say filter on this page, basic filtering on the basis of what I have put in over here. What is it appearing? Filter on this visual, filter on this page. And I will put category over here on filter onto this page. Yes, it is fine, right? So let me remove this also and let me do it once again. Filter on this page, I will put category over here. Let me remove this as well. Filter on this page, I will put category. Now you select anything. Let us take the furniture. So you will see on the all the visuals on the page are being filtered for furniture. Let me take technology. So both the filters are being, both the visuals are being filtered for furniture and technology. So in simple words, I can say whatever I am doing over here, it is impacting both the filters. My filter is impacting both the, or I should say all the visuals on this particular page. Let me make another, go to the another page. And here I will take a pie, which displays the sales on the basis of category. Let me make it something like this. And I will also like to take, let us take the funnel on the basis of sales, on the basis of subcategory. Here it goes. Right. Now, I will go over here. Let me remove this filter and I will put the category over here. Let me take the category and I will put the category on filter on all pages. Now you take furniture. It has impacted the visuals on this page. Let me see over here. It has also impacted this page. And not only the page, all the page which were there has been impacted. You see, it has been for furniture only. Okay, so it will impact all the pages, filter on all pages. Let us take furniture and office supplies or furniture and technology. So I'm getting furniture and technology over here and it will also impact this particular page. Okay, so this is known as filter on all pages. So three sections of filter, I told you, filter on this page, on this visual, filter on this page, and filter on all pages. Now let us see one more example over here, which is very useful. It is known as drill through. That is also a different type of filter we have, which is known as drill through. So let me take over here. Right. Let us take this. I will take the sales on the basis of region. regional sales and let me put the label also over here. Don't forget to click on the visual. I will display the data labels. I'm reducing the size a bit. And let me take a table also over here, a matrix, in fact, where I would like to display the sales on the basis of the region and the segment. Let's take region wise, segment wise sales is being displayed over here. Right. So I have taken, let me name it as region. Let us take another one. You have created these two visual on this page, and on the next page also you wanted to have a similar sort of a visual. So instead of creating the entire thing again, you can also duplicate the page. So I can right click over here and say duplicate page. So here I want, instead of region, I want the segment sales. And here I want segment and segment and category wise sales. Segment wise, category wise sales is being displayed. Let me name it as segment. Let us duplicate it once again. And I would like to take the category wise sales over here. Sorry. Let me put the category. And here I would like to take category and category and subcategory wise sales over here. I need to change the slight look of it. Here it is. Okay. Then, and let me name it as category. And I would also like to put the category into the legend. And last but not the least, I can duplicate this. Let me take subcategory. I've taken the subcategory over here, and I will take it as, let me display, instead of category, I would like to display subcategory sales. Subcategory sales is being displayed over here, and here also I want only the subcategory sales, something like this. Here it goes. Okay, and I can also, my bad. Let me show the data labels. Size data labels. Here it is. Let me make this. But yes, this is fine. Right. So these are what we are getting. Now, what was the objective? We are trying to do a drill through. Drill through, what do you mean by a drill through? It will give you a drilling feature over here. So let me go to the segment and you will see that. When you will scroll down, you will see a drill through over here. Add drill through field over here. So I can put region over here. I'm into the segment sheet, putting the region over here. Then I can go to the category sheet. Category sheet, and we can put segment. Here it is. Into the drill through field. Then I can go to the subcategory, and in the drill through field, I can put category. The category over here. Okay, it's done. And if you have noticed, you are getting a new button in the on the top over here. Now let's go to the region. You select anything. Let's take South. And the total sales of South is 391,000. You can right click over here and you will see there is an option called drill through segment. So you want to bifurcate the South region sales on the basis of segment. So let me click over here and you can see it has been bifurcated. Just see the total value 391,000. Let's take say home office. Home office is 74,000. Let me click on the home office. And I will right click over here and I will say drill through category. Drill through cat. Okay. Okay. You can say, right. We have covered on what, let me go back. So on the control click, I can click on to go back and we have taken home office and this, the total, revenue over here is 7,000. I can right click over here and I will say drill through category. Remember 74,000. See over here. I'm getting the 74,000 over here. Let me take furniture, which is 17,000. I will right click over here and I will say drill through subcategory. Here it is. So I'm getting the bifurcation of 17,000 over here. So I'm getting a drill through over here. You can click on this control, click on the button to go back. 74,000, 391,000. And if you'll go back, 29,297,201 is the total sales which has been generated. So here we have seen fourth type of filter, that is the drill through. Let us take one more example over here, which is a dynamic filter that is known as a slicer over here. So first of all, let me take the, let's create a visual which displays the sales on the basis of subcategory, subcategory sales. Let me display the data labels. And okay, that is fine. No much formatting. I will go back, click outside, and you will see there is a slicer. This is known as a dynamic filter. And to make it more appropriate, I can put the category into the legend. Right. Now I will take the category into the slicer. Oops. Here it is. So I'm getting the slicer over here. Now you want to talk about furniture. You click on furniture, only office supplies, only technology. If you want to see, select all, you can say control click. Okay, and you can also create something like we have done this, and let me put region. Right, so you have two levels of the slicer. You can click on the furniture. Furniture central region needs to be compared with office supplies central region. Now you can see you can select only one. So if you want to select multiple, you can use control click. So you are comparing central furniture sales from the central region with the office supplies sales from the central region. The two central region sales has been compared over here. Now let us try to do some. For the time being, I'm just removing it over here, and I can go to the formatting of this visual, and you have some selection control. You can go to the selection control, and by default it is single select. You can off, you can make it on. Now in any which ways, you can only select one out of the multiple. You will not be able to select multiple even if you click on control clicks. Okay, so that is a selection control. I don't want a single select. So now I have a multiple one. Now you know you have to do control click to select the multiple, but you can make this option off, select control click with control. So I will make it off, and now you will simply able to check. Okay, then we have a select multiple control with this is off. Show all by option. So here it is. We were not getting the all option. You can click on this drop arrow over here, and you are getting all. Then you have slicer headers. You can make it as off. So you can see on the top, if you have noticed, on the top it was mentioned the name of the field, that is category. So I can make it off. I don't want this, so I can make it off. Then you have items. If you wanted to do any formatting on the items, let's take the font color. Okay. Then size and all can be also taken from here. Then you can go to the background. Here it is. This is how you have created the slicer depending on your requirement. Right. So these are the major things which you have. Border, shadow, all are normal. You can do that. So here, this is how we can create a slicer over here. Another slicer we have is a date slicer. So let me take a line graph. What happened? We were talking about. Okay, we were talking about the slicer. So let me take a line chart over here. Let me take the sales on the basis of order date. Here it is. And let me put the category into the legend. Here it is. And now I will like to take a slicer. So I will have to click outside, and I will take a slicer over here. Let's take a slicer, and oh my bad, I have taken. Here it is gone. Here is the slicer. I have taken the slicer over here, and let me put the order date in this. Here it is. Now you can see that you are getting a date range. Here it is. So you can see we are getting in the within the specified date range. So you can specify the date range over here. Another option is you can click on this drop down arrow. Instead of order date, you can make it as a date hierarchy. And you will see as soon as I make it as a date hierarchy, it has been changed. So you can select, I want to compare. Let's take, I wanted to compare the 14 and the 17 or 16 and 17. So I'm getting the comparison of 16 and 17. I want all. So I can go over here, selection controls, multiple select with control is off. And I want show all button also. And now I will select all, everything is visible. So this is known as a date slicer. And you can click on this drop down arrow or like this. Let me clear it all. Now I wanted to take from the first quarter, January sales of 2014, which comparison to the January sales of 2015. So in the month of January, we can see technology and furniture was gone up, but office supplies, where is that? Sorry, this blue, office supplies, the sales has been dipped. Okay. So this is your, the slicers. This is the slicer we have. Right. This is a date slicer. Again, I have one more type of slicer, which I can show you over here quickly. Let me take a line chart. Okay. Or instead of line, let me take a bar chart. This will be better. Yes. And I would like to display the profit on the basis of subcategories. Here it is. I will also quickly display the data labels. Here it is. And the slicer. And I would like to put the profit into the slicer. Here it goes. So just like a date slicer, you are getting the profit value. You can specify that you wanted to see where the profit is within the specified range. You can also say zero over here and press enter. So where the profit is between zero to the specified range, or you can make it back and you can type in zero over here. So all the subcategories in which you have received losses is being displayed over here. Okay. So this is known as a number slicer, numeric slicers. So we have talked about the filters on this pages, that is filter, different type of filters, filter on the visual, filter on the page, filter on all pages, drill through. We have talked about the different type of slicers, text slicers, date slicers, numeric slicers, right? Second. Okay, right. Now, I'm skipping this part as of now because moving to something important because I have to show you how to create a report. The report which I have shown you yesterday, I want you in this module, in this 4 hours which you are spending with me, you should be at a position to create a report, right? So few of the visuals I have skipped over here so that I can tell you how to create a report, right? So the next topic which is coming up over here is inserting the objects in Power BI. Inserting objects in Power BI. So, okay, before that, let's have a feedback from you. How is it going? Repeating of the slicer. Okay, slicer repeating will be quite tough, but I can just give you a review of it. Slicer is basically, okay, let's have a quick look at it. Slicer, super, repeat slicer. Okay, hold on. So I will quickly tell you about the slicer. So this is a slicer icon. If you wanted to, the benefit of a slicer is creating a dynamic filter. The filter which can be used during the runtime. Your user will be able to use this filter. So once we will be creating the report, I will include the slicer in that. So you will have a better understanding of it. Okay. Now coming back to you, let's see. Okay. Great going, super, okay. And are you getting the value? Are you getting the values? Yes. I want a response from everybody. Quickly, please give me the response so that I can see your energy. Just show me the energy, how energetic you are in this session. Yes, wonderful. Yes, perfect. Great. Now I can see. Yes, you all are energetic. And this also, your energy give me the energy. So your energy is directly proportional to mine, right? If you will be energetic, I will be also energetic. And I will love to give you more and more, which I can within this session. Okay, thank you for the response. And let's proceed further very quick. Very soon, we will be able to create the report. So now we are talking about inserting of the object. There are the different type of objects which we can insert in a Power BI report, which are picture, shape, text box, button, URL, navigation, bookmark, drill through. So number of options over here. So let me go how to insert. So you will see there is an option called insert in the menu bar. You will be getting an insert option, and within the insert option, you will get few things like text box, button, shape, images. Let me take a text box. Text box is very useful. We can use it for creating the heading of the report. So I will say, inserting objects. Let me do some formatting of it. Let's change the color, increase the size, the alignment, the font as well. And I can increase the size of this text box. And let me put it over here. Right. Here it goes. Quick formatting of this title. There is no title. I have made it off any background color. Yes. Till now, you must be aware my favorite color, that is black. So I'm putting black over here. No specific reason. I like it. That's why I'm putting it. You can choose something more better. And background is fine. If you want to have border, you want to have shadow, you can put in some rounded corner back border. It looks nice. And let me put it as a golden color border. And let me change the size a bit. And yep, yes, it looks better now. Right. So here I have created a title stating inserting objects. So this is how we can have the text box. Now let us see few buttons. So there are different buttons over here. You will see many buttons. What is a button? Button is when you click on it, something will happen. So you will see few buttons are blank button where you will not have any action. You have to associate the action with it. And few buttons are the buttons which comes with the preloaded actions. Like we have the back button. Let me take the back button over here. I will put the back button at the bottom. Let me resize it. Here it is. So this is a back button. Let me click on any of the page. Let me click on this page and I will go to the page on the one which I was working. Now, if I will click control click on this button, it will automatically take me to the last page I have visited. Okay. So this is a back button. I haven't done this by default. It is coming with the respective action. I can go to the buttons once again. So we have right arrow, left arrow, the different type of buttons we have over here. Let me take a right arrow and I can put it at the bottom. Oops, sorry. Too big. Right button. Now you see control click, nothing is happening because it doesn't come with the action on it. I can go to the button if you want. Let's take a blank button over here. So this is a blank button we have taken over here. then you can go to the buttons. There is a Q&A button, so I can put a Q&A button over here. Then any other button you can check. I will say information button. Here it is. So randomly I have taken few buttons, so you can add any button you want, and dependently you can give some actions to it. We will just see that as well. Then we can go to the shape. We can go to the shape over here. And there are different shapes. Let's take an arrow shape over here. Here it is. Here it is, the arrow. Let me take the shape, and you can check anyone you want. Let me take this one. Oh, it's a circle. So any type of shape can be taken over here, like this. Then you have an image. You can also add an image over here. So let me take learn. Let's take this image. So I have taken a LearnBay image over here. And let's take an image. I would also like to take another image, say Google, and say open. Here it is. The Google image. So like this, I have inserted few objects over here. And if you wanted to do any formatting, background and all, so you can play around with this. You can do that formatting. And here is one more button, this Q&A button. So I also, let me put one chart over here so it will look better. I will take sales on the basis of subcategory. Here. Now you can see this Q&A button. I will say control click. Now it will ask you. So you can ask questions from Power BI. Total profit over time. Enter. So see, automatically it is giving you profit on the basis of daily profit, right? I want to have sales. The total sales is being displayed. Let me say profit. You're getting the profit. So you can ask questions from Power BI like this. Okay, I haven't done it. It is coming with a predefined action on it. Let us take this LearnBay, and you will see there is an option called action. I can make the action on. I will click on this drop down, and you will see various actions over here like back, bookmark, page navigation, Q&A, and web URL, right? So as it is an image, let's try to give it a URL, and let us take the URL over here. I've taken the Google over here, and let me go to this. I will make the action on. It is web URL, and I will specify the URL over here. That is google.com. If you want to give some tooltip, you can also give some tooltip. Say, go to Google. Go to Google. That's it. Press enter. Now you will move your pointer over here. You will be getting a tooltip which says go to Google. You will control click on it. It will open Google for you. Let me say LearnPay. Here it is. And let me take this LearnPay link and I will go over here. Action is URL and let me specify this. Press enter. Now you click on this. Let me close this one. Now you click on this LearnPay, control click, and you can see you are going to the LearnPay site. Okay. So that is the action URL. Then if you want to go, let's take another on the, this is a shape. I will try to put some action over here on action. So back action, we will put it on some page navigation. Let us take the page navigation and you want it to move to some different page. I will say I want it to move to page number 9. Okay. Done. Now you can control click on this. It has taken you to the page number 9. Let's go back here. Let me take it as this is a shape. Let me put on this blank button. Let me take a blank button and I will put an action on it. Let me put an action on it where I would like to take the type is back or yes, back. It will get you to a previous page and tooltip is go to previous page. Go to previous page. And if you want, you can also give some button text over here. I will write it as back. Here it goes. Now, let's say I opened this page. I'm back on the main page. I will click on back. It will take you me to the previous page I visited. Okay, so here I have shown you few of the options and let me go to the action once again. So I have talked about back, web URL, Q&A action. So if you want Q&A action, you can put on over here. Let's take action on. You can see on this. Here I am getting the by default a Q&A action. If you wanted to put a Q&A action, you can simply type in use this Q&A action. And here it goes. Now you click on this control click and you are getting the same box where you can ask in the questions. Let me close this. Now we have one more type of action that is drill through. So I will take over here. I'm taking this page over here. And here, if you will see, if I wanted to drill through, I have to select it and right click over here. And then I will go to the drill through and select. But I don't want this. And let's see if we can utilize some object. So I can say insert object. Sorry, not the text box. I will take some button over here. And let's take a right arrow. or I can also, yes, right arrow is fine. I am taking a right arrow button over here. Let me put it over here. Or I can take it to anywhere, it's fine. Okay, now I have taken the action as on. Let me go over here. I will make the action as drill through, and the destination is segment. Let me go to the segment. Here also I will take a button. Let me take this one. Let me put it over here. Action is on, and I will take drill through. Destination is category. I will go to the category. Let me insert a button. Let's take again the right-handed arrow. And right sided arrow, and I can go to the action, and let me make it as drill through, and I will say subcategory. Here it is. Now let's go to the region once again. I will select any of the region. Let's take West. Now you'll see, I will control click over here. No need to right click. I'm getting the details, 725,000. Let me take consumer, 362,000. Let me click on this. I'm getting 362,000. Let me take office supplies, 110,000. Let me click on this. I'm getting the bifurcation of 110,000. Okay, here it is. So I have created a button over here, and now the back button is by default there. Here it goes, right? So this is a drill through. Now we have one more interesting feature in the insert object. So let us take one more, and which is known as a bookmark. So for bookmark, I have to quickly create few visuals. So let me create over here. I will take the sales on the basis of subcategory, putting the data label as well. I will make a copy of this, and I would like to make it as, instead of subcategory, I will like to make it as category. Let's make it like this, category sales. Then okay, then I would like to take another one. So let me take here, I would like to take the sales on the basis of region, where I don't want any legend, no legends, and I want a all detailed label over here. Let me make a copy of it. I will convert it to a donut, where I would like to have, instead of region, let me take the segment. Here it is. Let me quickly create few buttons. So I can go to the insert buttons. I will take a blank button over here. Let me put it over here. quick formatting, I will say the button text as, let me name it as all, the color, let me take it as a golden only. Text size is, let's try to make it slightly bigger. And I will also give some different font over here. So you can click on the font. Yes, this looks good. Then no outline. Fill color. Let me make it as on. I've taken it as a black. Background, border, shadow. Black. And I will also make an action as on. And we will take a bookmark action this time. And let's see what will happen. So I have taken a bookmark over here. And I have to specify a bookmark. But currently, we do not have any bookmarks. So we have to create the bookmarks. So first of all, I will create the buttons. And then we will create a bookmark. So I can copy paste this button so that I do not have to do any efforts again and again. Let me change the button text. Yes. Let me create one more. And this I will name it as button text as category. Let me name it as subcategory. Let me name it as region. And let me name it as segment. Here it is. Now we will expect, first of all, we have to create the bookmarks. So for which I have to go to the view and you will see few sections over here. There is a bookmark section and there is a selection section. I can close the filter for as of now, right? You will go to the selection and you will see there is an eye icon in front of each of the this visual over here. So I say set one. One, I can add this. I will say add. I can rename this. And I can say all over here. Then let me hide all region, category, subcategory. I will name it as rename. Let me say. And I will name it as segment. Let me hide this and display region. I will say add. Let me rename it as, I'm creating a bookmark over here, region. Let me hide and display it as add, rename. Hide, display, add, rename, okay, right? So, and let me hide this also, and I will say add. And I will say none, or I will say blank. Blank. Here it goes. So I have created few of the bookmarks. I don't want this anymore now, right? And let me go over here. So here it is, subcategory. We have taken the subcategory over here. Let me take the region. I will take the region over here. Let me take the segment. I will take the segment over here. Here it is, the segment. Right. Now you see, now you click on category. Control click category. You are getting the category details. Control click subcategory. Region. Segment. None. In fact, all was not required over here. All, we are getting only one, right? So wherever you will collect, so it is, so this is, we have used a bookmark. So in one report only, you are displaying multiple visuals. Okay, so this is known as a bookmark actions. Very useful while creating the reports and all. Let me click on subcategory, here it goes. Okay, so this was the bookmark action. Let me go back to the PPT. So now the most important thing of this module coming up over here, which is creating a report in Power BI. So let's quickly create one report in the Power BI. So it is a one-time effort of creating a report in the Power BI, and then it will be dynamic, right? So let's try to quickly create a report. We will be creating a sales report over here. So let me first of all insert. Let me insert a text box over here. And where I will say Superstore sales summary. Let me increase the size. Center aligned. Here it is. Changing some font. Some color. This time I would like to take it as a green color. That's it. And quickly, I will give the background color to it. Black. That's it. And okay. Now let us create few more visuals over here. So first of all, I would like to take the subcategory sales. So I will take the sales on the basis of subcategory. We will do the formatting part later. Sales on the basis of subcategory. I would like to give the card over here, or the, I would like to give a gauge over here, which will represent the overall sales. So I would like to put the sales into the value over here. Let me reduce the size of this. And let me remove the data labels over here. And let me go to the gauge axis, and I will specify it as here it is. This is the overall sales. and the call out value. Here it is. And I don't want the title or the title. Let's put the title on and sales. Let me put it into the center. Here it is. Let me reduce the size a bit. Yes. And quick formatting of this, where I would like to give the background color as black. Here it is, right? So I have done the formatting also over here. I will create a copy of this and I want a similar one for profit as well. So here I would, instead of sales, I would like to display the profit. And quick formatting of the axis. Let me go to the gauge axis. Here it is. And yep, this is fine. And let me also take some label, this card over here, which I would like to display the category, the subcategory over here. Where I would like to put the subcategory in the data in the filter also. Instead of basic filtering, I will say top N, I will say top one on the basis of sales. Say apply. Max sales. Oops. Like this, you can also change the format over here. Few things. Okay, so max sales is of phones. And let us take few more visuals. I would like to take the slicer also over here, where I would like to put the region. And let me also take the state. Quick formatting of it. Selection controls. Multiple select with control is off. Select all is on. Selection header, I don't want slicer header. Items, I can take the font color as green. And let me take the background as black over here. Oh, bad. Reduce the size. Here it is. Oops. Let me make it like this. And this. Here it is, how it is appearing. Yes. And let me take another one. I would like to take this, the line chart, where I would like to display the sales on the basis of order date. And also bifurcated on the basis of category. Here it goes. This space is, so we have to adjust it as we have a limited space over here. Here it is. Okay, and let me create one more visual over here. That is this, where I would like to take the sales on the basis of category. Then I will take one more visual, where I would like to take the sales on the basis of region. Then I would like to take one more visual, where I would like to take the sales on the basis of segment. Here it is. Let me reduce the size. This is fine. Now we will quickly do some formatting, segment, year, this, all good. Okay. Let me go over here. I will put the data labels as on, and I don't want the title. Quick formatting, data color, changing the color to green. No title. And let me go to the x-axis. Color, I'm taking it as golden over here. Let me reduce the size of it. And title color. I don't want the title, that is the subcategory which is appearing. And this is fine. Data labels. Oh, sorry, I moved it over here. I can go to the x-axis also, and let me reduce the size of the labels. Display units, decimal, zero, and title is off. Grid lines also off. Okay. And that's it. Right, and I can give some. So it takes some time to do the formatting for the first time, but as we are, it is a one-time effort, we can definitely do that. Here it goes, and x. Let me make it as x axis is off, right? Or let me make it on. Correct. Now I can take this x-axis, y-axis. Background is fine. I can put the border over here. Let me put a golden color. Here it is, and I can implement the same formatting to the another bar chart as well. So I can format it. Copy format printer. I will use this. Here it goes. Let me increase the size. And I can also take the formatting over here and put it over here onto this line chart as well. Okay, some more formatting needs to be done. So I will not display the data labels over here in this. No data labels. No legends. That's it. Y-axis. Fine, I don't need it. This is fine. And let me take this format printer. Let me put it over here. In this also, I don't want the legends. Rest is fine. We have all details labeled. Decimal places 0, value decimal 0. And same, I will make it for this as well. Let me see the title. Title is off. Perfect. So this is a report which we have created. Region wise, segment wise, category wise, year wise, anything else which you can have over here more. Yeah, more or less it is fine. So this is your report which we have created. Now let's see, here this report is talking about the overall data. Okay, one more thing, if you want to give, see at the back, you can see there's some white background is appearing for the page. So you can click on the page. Let me click outside the page. And if you will go to the formatting option, you will get the page information where you can collect, see the page background color also. You can make it as black over here. And this is how it is appearing. So I have taken a darker background over here. Right, now see this page. Now you click on a particular region. Let's take Western region, and all your visuals are just giving the details of the Western region only. Let me talk about in the Western region. I wanted to talk about any particular state. I say Colorado.
Here it is. I am getting the sales for the Colorado over here.
You take any other, let's take California. You are getting the details of the California like that. So you can see it is dynamic. You want to talk about central region. All the visual are talking about the central region. Not only because of the slicer, it is interactive with respect to each of the visual. Let us take technology. Now your visual is talking only about technology. Let us take West region. Now your report is talking only about the Western region. Okay, so here it goes. So this is your final report which we create. This is your final output of Power BI. And once this report is ready, what comes next? So the next thing which comes up over here is okay. So how do you find this report? How is the report? How is the report? Great. Nice. Okay. Good. Thank you. Somebody has given me 100%. Thank you very much. Right. Perfectly. Thank you. So this is how we have created the report. You can see that is a one-time effort. We have created the report. Now what next? The report is ready to be shared with the audience. To share with the audience, I need something known as Power BI service, which is another product provided by Power BI. So let me quickly give you, we will not be able to go in detail of this, but I will definitely like to tell you how you can share it with your audience. So what I will do, first of all, let me save this. I will go to the file and I can click on the save button over here. I can save this. I am saving it onto the desktop superstore. Store summary. Okay. I will save this. So it has been saved. You can see in the title bar. Now you will see there is a button called publish. You will click on this publish. And also notice, can you see my name is appearing at the top, Rajiv Garg, because I have already logged into my Power BI profile. I have already logged into my Power BI profile, and you need to have a corporate email ID to create a Power BI profile. So it is asking me where to publish. So I will say there is something known as workspace. Workspace is nothing but a folder. So you said my workspace, and click on select. Now it is publishing, right? It is saying publishing superstore summary. Success, it has been published. Now let me click on this. So it will take me to my Power BI service account. So it is taking to the Power BI service account. Let me say sign in. I think I already have it. It must be signed in. Yes. Here it is. This is my Power BI service account. You can see my workspace, and let's try to see the report which we have just published. Superstore summary, right? You can open it over here. and here is the report. Now my report is machine independent. I can open it from anywhere, from any machine. I just have to log into my Power BI service and I can take it over here. Okay. And if in this visual, if you wanted to focus on any of the visual, when you move your pointer over here, you will see there's an option called focus mode. You click on this and you will be getting that visual on the entire screen. So that is known as a focus mode. You can click on this and you can see focus. It is appearing in a focus mode. Okay. So like this, you can highlight a particular visual over here. So now your data is onto the cloud platform of Power BI. So Power BI service is a cloud platform of Power BI. And okay, now if you wanted to share it, there's an option called share. Okay, sorry. Okay, so of this report, you can share it using the Outlook. You can share it in using the Teams if you are using Teams, or you can also get the link. You can copy the link over here and you can share this link to anyone. Suppose I will put in it into the chat and let's see what happens. I have put in the link into the chat and press enter. Right. Now, if anybody wants to check, you can click on this link. So it is as simple as that. You can click, send this link to anybody. But if you will click on this link, what will happen? Okay, quickly, can you somebody try? Can you people please try and let me know what happened when you clicked on the link? I have to disclose something. Please click on this link quickly. Are you asking for sign in? Yes, I have got only sign in. Okay, more responses quickly. Click sign in, asking for login. Absolutely correct. Right. So by this, absolutely, that's it what I wanted to prove, that it will ask you to log in to the Power BI service. So you must be. Right. Can we get the data set? Yes, why not? I can definitely share it with you. The admin team will sending it to you. Just with the recording and all, you will be able to get the data set. Okay. So, sorry. So one point which I wanted to prove over here, that you, if you have shared it with someone, that particular person should also have Power BI login account. Then only he will be able to view this particular report. Okay, then so Power BI service account is required in order to view the report. Okay, so this has been created and yes. And you can also do one thing. Let's take click on subscribe if I can do it right now. No, I won't be able to. Okay. So this is how we can create a report and publish it onto the online. That is Power BI service. And if you want, see, here you also have an option of, you can go download, print, and export. See, this is a wonderful feature of export. You have put it into the Power BI service and you can export it to the PDF, Excel, or the PowerPoint. Let's say I want a PowerPoint of this. Now, what do you want? Only export current page or all the pages? So I have number of pages. I don't want to take all. I'll say only the current one and say export. It says export to PowerPoint in process. So it is automatically creating a PowerPoint presentation on your behalf. Take some time to create. Yes, it has ready to download. You can see at the bottom, we have the report, the PowerPoint presentation. Let me say show in folder. Here it is, Superstore summary. This is a PowerPoint presentation created by Power BI. Here it goes. Here it is. So this is the first title page created by Power BI. And you can move to the next page. Here is your visual. And please do not expect this to be dynamic, right? It will not be dynamic, but if you will click anywhere on this, it will take you to the Power BI service. Nice. How is it? How do you find this report? Good, bad? Nice. Too good. Right. Okay. So what do you think? What all you have learned so far? Thank you for your response. Whatever you have learned so far, will you be able to work in Power BI now? Do you feel confident about Power BI? If confident, type in C. Type in C if you feel confident in the Power BI now. Wonderful. Right. So that is, you have got some value out of this module. And that was all agenda behind taking your so precious 4 hours. You have given your, my name is Rajiv Garg. If you want to search, you can search on online. You will get the details. The rest, I think admin team has, I am expecting a DEX. Okay, yes, we have a limited time, so I won't be able to get into the DEX. And I will say that I have just introduced you to Power BI. There are a lot many things in the Power BI which we can do, like the transformation of the data using the DEX functions. There are a number of functions and the different type of columns which can be created in the Power BI, and putting the calculation, creating, say, measures, and then we have data modeling in Power BI. So again, we will not be able to cover all the things in 4 hours. Yes, but we have tried to bring you to a level so that Power BI is not a stranger for you. Please no drawings, and you will be able to use Power BI. Okay, right. So this is all what I wanted to share in this particular session of the Power BI. In the 4 hours, this is what I wanted to share with you. And this is it from our side, right? I hope you like this module, and I would like to appreciate, and I would like to thank all of you so that you have been so participative. I have seen a wonderful people around with me, and you have done a very good job. You are so much interactive, and that is how you get the value, right? So that is from my side. Thank you very much. Thank you for attending this module. This is Rajiv Garg. Please take care, and I wish you a great career ahead. Thank you very much. Bye-bye and take care.